Much love. Spread love. Hashtag spread love.
Hashtag spread love. And on that note, hello and welcome to WCFR. See, yes, I did spell it correctly. The music hour for the 48-hour telethon. How are you doing, Kate?
I'm lovely. How are you, David?
I am doing pretty good. I had to get a little bit of a, you know, more spunk with the glasses, even though it's night already.
I love it. Yeah. I love it. Okay.
Other than that, well,
am I early? I think I'm early.
You might be a little early, but we can chit chat about music right now.
Yeah.
As the other guys are coming in, what inspired you to sing, to be vocal with the words?
I've been singing since I was little. I was an early talker. And as the rumor goes, because, you know, I don't think there were too many video cameras back when I was one. But my parents swear I sang happy birthday to myself on my first birthday. So I think it's just always been in me. So I've been singing ever since, really. And, you know, I studied voice and, you know, singing, doing what I can when I can do it.
I can dig that. Yeah, because it is one of those things where music, you can obviously learn music, but most musicians just have it within them, whether it be in their blood, whether it be relatives have been doing music, whether professionally or not.
Yeah.
It's one of those things where it runs in your blood, you know?
I think it can. It can. But you can definitely learn it. And I think everyone should learn an instrument of some kind, or take a voice lesson, or join a choir, or learn the ukulele. Just something. Even a tambourine, you know? My dad always says he plays the radio.
Ooh.
That's what he plays. He plays the radio.
I can dig that. Yeah, it's an instrument that you can play. You can you know, manipulate the volume knobs and change the channel whenever you
want. Dad joke. Yeah. Yep. So
that's pretty cool. What is your favorite instrument? Now, do you play multiple instruments, or is it just one instrument that you play?
Well, primarily I'm a vocalist, so usually I have instrumentalists I'm working with. However, I took piano lessons as a kid, and then I played the trumpet in middle school and high school. I was in the pep band for basketball season, and then in high school I sang with all the choirs and all that kind of stuff. And then when I got into college, I was singing in jazz choir and was in, you know, like all the specialty choirs in college and that kind of thing. And I really actually didn't learn. I mean, I played piano, played trumpet, and then I always wanted to play guitar, but I actually didn't learn until just a few years ago when I went back to school for music therapy. And, you know, I have so much admiration for people who play an instrument and accompany themselves, because it is such a different beast. I'm used to other people accompanying me, and I have mad respect for instrumentalists. But then when you're up at that net, like when you're playing an instrument and singing at the same time, it took me a while to like connect those parts of my brain. And drummers blow my mind. They have like four appendages going at once, and I can't do that.
Yes. But, yeah. Cause it's kind of like doing the trick where, you know, like, you tap your head and then you rub your belly type of thing. Or the one where you go one finger one way,
and then
the other one the other way, which I can do. And like a little bit on me, I do play a couple instruments. I'm not good at them. I always say I like to play stringed instruments.
Uh-huh, yes.
Guitar, ukulele.
Oh, me too. Cool.
I could pick up a banjo.
Okay.
Pretty much anything that looks like a guitar.
Okay, string. Yeah, you're a string guy. Okay.
Except for piano, because technically, well, at least the grand piano is strings.
Right. Yeah. But, depends who you talk to. That's either, you know, some people consider it.
It's like, you know, Coke or Pepsi. What is it? They're both sugar drinks.
Yeah.
They're both sugar drinks.
They are. They keep you caffeinated.
Yeah.
Like a Bobby's Red Bull.
Yes.
Caffeinated, which
I'm pretty sure right now he's drinking three of them in a row. I'm sure
he's chugging them in between all of these different groups of people. Yeah. Yes.
So again, awesome. thank you for joining in. As the other musicians join in, we can start off with you. And if you want to play a couple tunes, I guess on our side would be if you want to introduce the song title and then go from there.
Yeah.
We do have a couple time slots, but again, if somebody doesn't show up, you get to play longer.
I don't know if I have enough music. Yeah, you know.
Even if it's Jingle Bells, Batman Smells. Well,
Yep. I know. I'm like, where are these other people? Where are they?
She's not supposed to be the first one. Oh, well, thank you for joining WCFR live.
Live.
Right from our closets, because we are both inside closets.
Technically
offices.
I know, right?
Yes.
It's an office.
Where's my tie? I need a tie. I'm in an office.
Right. I know. I changed my shirt from earlier. I was like, I picked out Western music because of Vengeance Turns.
Okay, I can do that.
And I said, can I play like cowboy songs? Because it kind of, you know, it goes along with the movie.
Yes.
So, yeah. And, you know, I'm from Idaho originally. So I was joking around with him that I was typecast because I'm from Idaho and, you know, nice and podunky and country. And
it's one of those things where, you know, if you fit the mold, you'll be part of it, you know. So it's part of the screening process, you know, especially for films. You have to fit the part, otherwise you don't get it.
It's true. That's what happens. You know, it this business, unfortunately, it's about your looks first.
Yes.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, especially me being the casting director for Vengeance Turns, like, just going through the lists and just all I was doing was looking at headshots.
Yeah.
Literally.
Yeah, because that's what you have to do.
And then from there, every now and again, I would look at the reel. Every now and again, would look at if they left a note or cover letter or whatever. But
yeah,
unfortunately, it's all about the looks. But today, it's all about the voice.
The voice. Ta-da!
The voice.
Yeah. I know. All those voice lessons have paid off.
I need voice lessons.
Hey, we can trade.
Do you teach voice on a side note?
I used to. I still could. Yeah. I haven't in a while. But yeah, I'm definitely capable. I spent, you know, that my undergrad is in vocal performance. So
okay.
Yeah.
So to our listeners, if you ever need a lesson.
Yeah.
You know, and feed an artist at the same time. You know?
Right. Yeah.
You know, it's a give and take. You know,
I'll teach you everything I don't know.
Exactly. And everything that she does know, it'll be extra.
Exactly. I charge extra for what I do know.
Exactly. So, yeah. So if you want to start us off.
Sure. I will. I have my music here. There we go. This is a song my family, hopefully you can hear this all right. My family sang a lot of, like, I call them campfire songs or, like, just family sing-along songs. And this one was always a hit. My Uncle Bill always sang it. Old cowpoke went riding out one dark and windy day. On a ridge he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw, all plowing through the ragged sky, and up a cloudy draw. Their brands were still on fire and their hooves were made of steel. Their horns were black and shiny, and their hot breath he could feel. A bolt of fear went through him as they thundered through the sky. For he saw the riders coming hard, and he heard their mournful cry. Yippee-yay! Yippee-yo! Ghost riders in the sky. The face is gone, their eyes are blurred, their shirts all soaked with sweat. He's riding hard to catch that herd, but he ain't caught him yet. Cause they've got to ride forever on that range up in the sky, on horses snorting fire. As they ride on, hear their cry. As the riders loped on by him, he heard one call his name. Wanna save your soul from hell, riding on our range. A cowboy, change your ways today, or with us you will ride. But trying to catch the devil's herd across these endless skies. Yippee-i-yo, yippee-i-yay. Ghost riders in the sky. Ghost
riders
in the sky. So.
Quasha! Quasha! Yeah.
Get along, little doggies. Yeah.
Rawhide. Wait, wrong one.
Yeah. Yeah, that's Ghost Riders in the Sky. There's a lot of old cowboy groups who have made that song famous, and Johnny Cash sang it. Yeah. And mm-hmm. There's a group called Riders in the Sky as well. Yeah. So
yeah, because usually Johnny Cash is the first thing that comes to mind, just because I really enjoy mm-hmm. listening to Johnny Cash.
Yeah. All those old guys like Johnny Cash, Hank. Willie Nelson. And of course the women. We can't forget the women, because, you know, Loretta Lynn, June Carter, all mm-hmm. those ladies, like mm-hmm. old school country. That's the kind of stuff I like. I do like some of the new pop country, I won't lie. It's on my car radio a lot. But yeah, there's lots of good like old country music out there.
Yeah.
Yeah. And finding songs for today too. I learned a little bit of history about, you know, some of the music. So that was fun.
I can dig that. Yeah, because it is one of those things where, like, some of the old school country, it's more lyrical.
Yes.
Yeah. Again, because, like, modern music in general tends to mm-hmm. go towards repeating the same verse over and over and over again over a cool beat.
Yeah.
Versus back then, it's simple guitar.
Yes.
With great lyrics.
Yeah, it's true. They always tell a story. That's the cool thing. Yeah. I have a friend, Dr. Joanna Zotero, a little shout out to her. She's a professor and just recently got her doctorate, and she has been studying cowboy music, like music of the West. And so it's been interesting, you know, to learn from her some of the things that she's studied about how music progressed in our country with country music and Western songs. And, you know, a lot of times they did tell a story, and they actually were kind of like guideposts of how to get to a place from another place, because that was the words of the song. That's how you got there on your horse.
And sometimes that's how you remember.
Yeah, exactly.
That's the easiest way to remember, if you just hum it
right,
you know, to a beat, something that can keep you entertained while your brain just puts it into your cerebral cortex and you just remember it.
Yes.
It's easier to do.
Yeah. As a music therapist, we use that a lot. You know, that's a way to help people process information and to get it to stick. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. And we're going to also, Jack Norris is.
I see him now.
Is he coming in? Hello. How are you? Can you hear us? Let us know when you are locked and loaded. But if anything, we can go with another song in the meantime.
Sure, I'll play.
If you're good for it.
Yeah, I'm good. This song is an old one, and my dad used to sing this to us as kids. It was probably the only song that I ever really heard him sing, and it's called "Home on the Range." But it was interesting. I found out it was actually a cowboy kind of poetry story that was written, and then a man wrote like this music to it a little bit later, actually right around the timeline for Vengeance turns right around that time, 1874.
Okay.
Yeah, 1874 is when this song was put to music. So
yeah,
might be familiar to some people. Oh, give me a home where the buffalo roam and the deer and the antelope play. Where seldom is heard a discouraging word and the skies are not cloudy all day. Home, home on the range, where the deer and the antelope play. Where seldom is heard a discouraging word and the skies are not cloudy all day. Where the air is so pure and the zephyr so free and the breeze is so balmy and light, that I would not exchange my home on the range for all of the city so bright. Home, home on the range, where the deer and the antelope play. Where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day. My favorite is to make it sound really like super, super country. Super southern, like as cow pokey as I can get. Oh, give me a land where the bright dime sand blows leisurely down in the stream, where the graceful white swan goes a gliding along like a maid in a heavenly dream. Then I would not exchange my home on the range where the deer and the antelope play. Where seldom is heard a discouraging word and the skies are not cloudy all day. Yeah.
I like that.
It's a little fun. A little fun to do it like I wouldn't sing it.
Yeah, I know, right? It's definitely, because it goes down to that country voice, that like over-exaggerated country voice reminds me, again, there's a couple voices that you've probably heard me do when we do like the radio novellas, where it's more of on the, on me it's the Adam's apple, that just moving it up and down where it goes like this.
It's almost like you're gonna yodel.
Yes, it's almost like yodeling.
Yeah,
except I can't really yodel.
Yodeling's hard. Much. Yeah. I picked a song too that had a little yodeling in it, so I was practicing. It's not as good, you know. There are some people who can yodel, like my papa could yodel, but I'm kind of mediocre yodeler. No. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. I know I can't yodel. Like, I feel like I have too much of a deep voice for yodeling. I don't have a deep voice. I'm more of a baritone. But I feel like when you yodel, you have to have a higher pitch. I don't know. Is it just me?
I think it's a technique, really.
Okay.
I don't know. It just feels kind of like.
Yodeling?
I don't know if I'm doing it right. No offense to anyone out there who can really, really yodel. Because, there are some people.
Yeah.
They have competitions, I think, in Europe.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the yodeling competitions.
Yeah, which is amazing.
Yeah.
It's amazing to watch. It's amazing to just even try to do it.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, but my kids were looking at me a little funny when I was just
yodeling.
Pretend yodeling. It was pretending for sure. Oh,
thank you so much for the great songs. I'm just trying to see if Jack Norris if he can hear us, I know his video is off currently.
I can hear you fine. Can you hear me?
Oh, sweet.
Oh, we can hear you.
We can hear you. Yes.
Oh, wonderful.
Yes. Hey guys. If you want to turn on your video, we can do a couple songs with you.
Let me see if I can do that.
Yeah. Again, thank you, Kate, so much.
You're welcome.
We're trying to see how many can we get in a row. Welcome, Jack. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great. How are you guys doing?
We're doing pretty good. Lovely. Pretty good. So you got to hear Kate a little?
Yeah. Home on the Range. It's awesome. That's awesome. That's something my grandfather used to put me to sleep with, man. I love that song.
That's a good old song. Yeah.
So random question. Can you yodel, since we were talking about yodel?
No. I cannot yodel to save my life. I've never been asked before. First for me.
So close. Audience, can you guys yodel? Let us know in the comments if you guys can yodel.
You owe us $10.
Yeah, I know, right? No, take a video yourself. Tag us, Canfever Radio. We would love to see you yodeling.
Yes.
Because we've been talking a little bit about yodeling, and it's a hard technique, but it's always entertaining to see somebody yodel.
Attempt it.
And attempt to yodel at the same time.
Yeah.
Really hard. Really good yodeling is actually really good to listen to. I mean,
it is. It's really cool. It's
remarkably, yeah. Really, when it's well done, it's not that hard in the ears, man.
Yes, mm-hmm. It really is, and it's a again, like all music, done well, it's always enjoyable. Like all art, I suppose. Like all art, yes.
I agree.
But now, if it's all right, with Jack, if you're ready, if you want to do a couple songs with us,
I would love for to. Us, that would be great. I'm honored to be a part of this. This is great. I've been doing a little research. I just kind of fell into this. A friend of mine posted something, said, "Hey, do you know any musicians?" And a friend of mine tagged me, and I'm like, "Yeah, I would love to be a part of this."
That's awesome.
Like so cool.
That's a great thing, and I'm looking forward to seeing the results. Yeah, it's gonna be great.
Yes, awesome. Thank you so much. And again, Kate, thank you so much. Feel free to stick around if you want to stick around.
Yeah.
And be part of the audience member side, because it was just me, like, just going along with your music, you know? So, like, having somebody else, like, okay, cool. It's not as awkward, because it's not just one person.
All right.
But yeah, if you want to introduce the title of your song, and then if you want to go for it, and we would love to listen to you play.
Thank you. I've been trying to, you know, like I said, I've had a couple of days to figure out what songs I want to play, and a few of them just kind of stuck to my mind, and this one's called Walking in the Sun, and I hope you like it. Things have been going wrong long enough to know everything is right. Been walking in the dark long enough to know, finally seeing the light. Been losing long enough to know when I finally won. Even the blind man can tell when he's walking in the sun. Cried enough tears to know, just feeling called a smile. Been bottom rung long enough to know when I'm going in style. Been running long enough to know there's no more need to run. Even the blind man can tell when he's walking in the sun. At my back, and I'm sailing on a ship that's overdue. Well, I've blown so many chances that I ain't gonna blow this chance with you. Well, I've seen enough bad time to know the good times begun. Even the blind man can tell when he's walking in the sun. Walking in the sun. Oh, I lost you. Hang on one second.
There you go. There you go. No, it was me. I was muted.
Woo! Oh,
okay. Okay. That's awesome. I really enjoyed that.
Thank you.
And the title for that was again?
Called Walking in the Sun.
Walking in the Sun. Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Just for the audience members, remember, Walking in the Sun.
Walking in the Sun. Cheers to you.
Cheers. And then,
this is great, man. I'm loving this. This is a great thing. I've been reading up, and I'm kind of stoked to be a part of this. This is great.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, it's definitely something that we've been trying to figure out how to do as much original content as possible. We're going to have one of our artists that will play a little bit later on join us, so we can have more of an audience membership besides our lovely audience that lives in cyberspace. Hello, cyberspace.
Facebook, hello, cyberspace. YouTube,
Twitch. But yeah, it's definitely something that we've been wanting to do for a while.
That's great, man.
Hello, I'm Corey. How are you doing?
Yay.
Corey is one of my friends that I've known for a long time. He's another actor, musician, just overall great artist. So it's definitely one of those things where we wanted to grow as a community with Cabin Fever Radio, and doing the music aspect of it was something that we've been planning for a while, but we weren't sure how to do it. So right. We were like, well, if we're going to do a telethon, it's got to have music. Right. That's where we reached out with our friends, so that's how we got Kate, Jack, Corey, and then another artist, Shayne Moore, who'll probably be joining us in a bit.
Wonderful.
But yeah, it's going to be a fun night for sure. So, Jack, if you want to do another song, introduce the song, and then we'll be all ears.
That's great.
Yes.
First of all, the Liquid Courage. This is for all you friends, all you everybody out there.
Yes,
this is a great
I know.
Thing. Cheers. Glad to see you guys. Yeah. Wonderful. Cheers to you guys. Happy Friday. Happy Labor Day.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And likewise.
And, woo, that was good. I'm a big fan of Sting, so I'm going to do a Sting song. Is covers okay? Can I do a cover? I'm going to do a cover. I've been obsessed with Sting for like years, so I'm going to do a stripped down version of one of his songs, and it's one of the ones that I really love playing, and I hope you enjoy it as much as I love playing.
Awesome.
The night turned cold, the stars looked down, your hold yourself on the cold, cold ground. Wake the morning in the stranger's coat. No one would you see. Ask yourself, who watch for me? Only a friend. Who could it be? It's hard to say it. I hate to say it. It's probably me. When your belly's empty, your hunger's so real, you're too proud to beg, you're too dumb to steal. Search the city for your only friend. No one would you see. Ask yourself, who could it be? Solitary voice speaks out and set me free. It's hard to say it. I hate to say it. It's probably me. Not the easiest person I ever got to know. It's hard for us both to let our feelings show. Some would say, she let you go your way, you'll only make me cry. But if there's one guy, just one guy, lay down his life for you and die. I hate to say it, I hate to say it, it's probably me. When the world's gone crazy, it makes no sense. There's only one voice that comes to your defense. The jury's out, and your eyes search the room. One friendly face is all you need to see. But if there's one guy, just one guy, lay down his life for you and die. I hate to say it, I hate to say it, it's probably me. I hate to say it, I hate to say it, it's probably me. I hate to say it, I hate to say it, it's probably me.
So is it probably you?
It's probably me. Yeah. That's a song I sing for my sister on her birthday, because she's just a wreck. So I'm like, you know, if you need a friend, the only friend you got in the world, it's this guy, right?
Yeah, I can dig that. That's pretty cool.
Thanks, yeah, man.
And then coming in right now will be Shayne Moore, the fourth musician that we have for you guys tonight. And again, thank you, Jack Norris.
Thank you so much
for the lovely songs. And then one thing before we go on to another song, I do want to thank the audience members for tuning in. Again, the reason why we're doing the 48-hour telethons is to make sure that we can make Vengeance Turns, the motion picture, even better than it already is. Because we are making Vengeance Turns. And with your help, we'll be able to increase the production value as well as the amount that we'll be paying the talented actors that you'll be meeting throughout the 48-hour telethon. Now, don't get me wrong, we are making the movie and everyone is getting paid, but we want to make sure that we can increase the amount that these artists are getting paid. So with your contributions, that's how we'll be able to make it happen. Our Indiegogo is live. The links are in the description below. So again, go check it out. Every penny counts and is truly appreciated. Plus, we have great bundles available for you guys for your contributions, from being some of the first to watch the film, as well as t-shirts like this one. We have pins, posters, and other accoutrements, including hats. And there's even a couple tiers where you can have your name be part of the credits in the film. So again, go check it out. Only available on our Indiegogo campaign. So please, you can go there now. It doesn't take that long. Give us a couple bucks and we'll be right here. And you will be on your way to supporting an amazing group of artists tell a powerful story. And if you have the same passion as we do, share it with as many friends as you can. And again, thank you so much for being here and making this possible. And I hope you are enjoying the lovely music that you're hearing today. And again, going back down the list, we had Kate Comstock, Jack Norris, Corey Storey, and Shayne Moore. How are you guys doing today? Today, tonight. I don't have windows here, so I can't really tell what the weather's outside. If we want, we can do another song. How are you doing, Corey? Good. Can you hear us? Can we hear you?
Yeah, I just turned. I had myself on mute earlier because I didn't want to interrupt and be all loud and weird sounding and stuff, as I tend to be.
it's a live telethon. Come on, you can be loud and weird. No,
I had some like clunking and junking and
kerplunking. I can dig that. We'll do a quick little round robin. We've been doing two songs per artist right now, and then from there. Towards the end of the night, because we'll probably go over 9. If you guys want to stick around, we'll do a couple more songs, but I just want to make sure that everyone can get a spot in our telethon. So, Corey, if you are available, if you are ready, we would love to hear something from you. If
let me grab my little guitar.
Your tiny guitar.
My guitar. Well, it's actually my dad's guitar.
Ooh.
I'm in my dad's studio right now.
I can
so so lucky.
It definitely looked weird from the last time I was at your place. It's like I don't remember you.
Yeah, I can imagine.
I had to wash the walls behind me. I'm set up in my bedroom.
I was like, should I like turn it just to like be in a corner? And I was like, well, I mean, I have this great setup behind.
Dude, that's great. That's a great. Yeah, that's awesome.
If this blanket wasn't here, you'd see all my shirts.
I decided to
wear pants. Actually, how many of us wearing pants?
I think only Corey, because we told them to, but
that's lovely.
Yeah, hopefully the sound, does my sound okay on your end?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, sweet.
Yeah.
Cool. I was having some technical difficulties and I started like going into like, I'm not stressed. I'm not stressed at all right now.
Yeah.
Whatever.
I wasn't in your position right before the.
Dude, I have no idea
telephone.
How you're doing all of this.
Yeah,
well, actually, I do because I've seen you at work, David, and you are straight up a magician. So,
thank you.
Yeah, so, thank you for all that you do.
Oh, thank you for being a part of it.
Absolutely, always. So I wrote this song pretty recently. Here we go.
Less screen time, more me time. I will make it okay. Used to paint the picture on my face, and in it my own was erased. I lost my true sense of self, creating one for someone else, and now I'll make it okay.
It's crystal clear, I cleaned the mirror, and then it's someone else appeared. Who's that staring back at me? I think he's come to set me free, and now I'll make it okay. Ooh, me. I will make it okay. This abundant flowing energy used to fill me with anxiety, but once I started channeling, I found it so empowering, and now I'll make it okay. Sure, I've sinned, got plenty of flaws, might have even broken a couple of laws, but I lost my grip on judgment. I'm learning how to own my shit, and now I'll make it okay. We'll make it okay. Ooh, ooh, ooh. We'll make it okay. With less me time, more me time. I will make it okay.
That's great. That was awesome.
You better make it okay.
Yeah, I'm gonna make it okay. I gotta make it okay for me. You gotta make it okay for you. We're all gonna make it okay for each other.
Yes. Oh, and a question that I did not ask that I asked Jack, and Kate probably already knows where I'm going with this. Corey and Shayne, do you guys know how to yodel?
Yodel.
Yodel.
Exactly.
Yodel. 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 That's
good. That's good.
Bad yodeling is really bad yodeling.
But it's very entertaining for our viewers. It's all
I would definitely, like, if that was a requirement on a, like, submission for an acting part, I would definitely not put myself up for it. And I put myself up for a fair amount of things that I do not know how to do well.
Like, I go for, like, yeah, I can play 17. I can play a 17-year-old boy, but I can't yodel.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I can't do a 17-year-old yodeling kid. No.
My age range is between, like, 12 and 48. Yeah.
18 to look younger.
Yes.
Yeah, right.
And on the yodeling aspect of it, Corey, if you want to go and do one more song, and then from there we'll kick it off over to Shayne. And then from after Shayne, then we'll do a round robin from there. Is that cool?
Sounds great.
Sounds good.
Cool.
Sweet. Yes.
Whenever you're ready.
Look me in the eye, your heart will turn to stone. When you see the truth, it would make my favorite statue. I really don't want to hurt you by exposing the truth. So let's just lie in each other's arms instead of testifying what we've done all along. And cover the truth. You never find love again. You never fall in love again.
trying every weekend. I can never fall in love again. I can never fall in love again. But trying every weekend. Don't look me in the eye. My heart will turn to stone when I see your truth. You'll make a better statue with no way to deceive you, showing only the truth. Let's just lie in each other's arms instead of testifying what we've done all along. And cover the truth. I can never fall in love again. I can never fall in love again. But I've been trying every weekend. I can never fall in love again. I can never fall in love again. But I've been trying every weekend. So don't look me in the eye. Our hearts will turn to stone when we see the truth. Though they'd make blissful statues, neither of us can choose to show the truth. So we'll just lie in each other's arms instead of testifying what we've done all along and cover the truth. We can never fall in love again. We can never fall in love again. 'Cause we're trying every weekend. We can never fall in love again. We can never fall in love again. Again. 'Cause we've been trying every weekend. Every weekend.
Great. That was awesome.
That's awesome.
Good job. Good job.
Thank you so much, Corey, for that. Yes, and again, try to find love. Not just on the weekends, every single day. Not just on the weekends.
Yeah, I got a lot of love for myself now, so.
It's good. Yeah. That's good. And that's usually how you start. You have to love yourself before you can love somebody else.
It's true.
Amen, brother.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen to that. Yes, amen to that.
And on that note, how are you doing, Shayne? How's it going?
You know what? I'm doing okay. I've settled myself down a little bit. I've had a beer and tequila, and I'm okay now.
I can dig that. Yeah.
Party on.
I see it's Friday.
It's a holiday weekend. You get some whiskey, you get some tequila, you get a telethon. This is a great night, people. Come on.
Yeah. I see the jug back there. What is it?
My friends
Let's
out at
get
the
crazy.
Brewery, they set me up.
That's awesome.
Nice.
You got to have your favorite beer for this. And I said, okay, we'll do it.
I can dig that. It's like, I'm literally in the same.
If you're ever in Elizabethtown, Kentucky, make sure you stop by the Flywheel. They're great people. They have great souls.
I can dig that. Yeah. Because it is one of those things where I really enjoy craft beer. And I have a local brewery that I've been going to for a long time now, like over 5+ years. I've met the owners. I know pretty much all the staff. And again, I'm
there too.
I have artwork there. Yes.
Artist.
Yeah, it's like I'm trying. It's right now. It's all about you guys. But again, shout out to Smog City. They have great beer as well. So if you're ever
nice
in the Torrance area, a little bit south of LA, okay. Smog City is where it's at.
All right. Awesome.
So on that note, Shayne, if you want to introduce the title of the song and then play us a little ditty, play the thing, strum the strings.
Do the thing with the place.
Yeah.
We're going to see what we can do with this, fellas and madame. Uh-huh. I when Bobby asked me to do this last week, last Thursday, I thought, man, you know, I'd really like to have a new song for this show. Thursday night, it hit me. I'm like, oh, okay, I can do this. So Friday I wrote the song. So I'm brand new at this song, okay?
Woo! Cool. All right, new song.
All right.
Yes. Let's debut it here. Only on the 48-hour telethon.
Debut.
Great. Yeah. Love it.
Yeah.
This song's called No Justice Now, and it kind of goes with the theme of a lot of what Bobby had to say. I didn't know we were so kindred souls, you know. But anyway, I'll see what I can do, and I hope y'all like it. Yeah. I got to remember the chord it starts on. I woke up this morning to a dreadful world filled with desperation. This is not the country I grew up in. What's become of my beloved nation? Lies tweeted out from the top. Minute by minute, you know it just won't stop. And there's no justice now. How can we witness this and not figure it out? You know there's no justice now. When someone can be shot because they're not white enough, you know there's no justice now. No justice now. There's no justice now. An incredulous narcissist, this wannabe king, is fading us dry as we die in the streets. Screams of how he's made America great, inciting the violence and applauding the hate. Killing the planet for his insatiable greed, funneling our money into his own company. And there's no justice now. Along with our liberty, he's wiping it out. You know there's no justice now. The Orange Klansman is stomping it down. Oh no, there's no justice now. Help me, there's no justice now. Help us all. There's no justice now. Oh no, there's no justice now. I say there's no justice now. There's no justice now. Vote him out. Thank you. I love you all.
Yeah.
That's a song I can get behind.
Yeah.
Yeah, right? Oh, yes. Man.
That's a song I can get behind.
Yes. It's very true to the times. And again, yeah, thank you for writing that again in short notice. Because again, I think out of everyone we did tell, I think I told Corey what, a couple days ago, but everybody did have a profound admiration that we had towards you guys. That's why we invited you guys to be a part of it. And because we wanted to make sure that the music that we told was heartfelt, and it shows for sure. And I really do enjoy the song you just did, Shayne.
Thank you very much. Me too, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Indeed.
Yes.
Well, if that wasn't your particular brand of whiskey, this one might make you smile.
I wrote this
I don't know how many years ago. I wrote it like everything else while I was working, and had asked a friend to help me out because I never could get the music going. And right after I asked him, I wrote the music to it. So I was like, well, sorry, man, thanks. You know, but anyway, this is called One More Beer, and it's a little bit more upbeat. I need me one more beer and one more cigarette. I need me one more beer, baby, one more cigarette before I hop off this bar stool and get this out of rest. Well, I've been here all night since 4:45. That's when I read your letter telling me goodbye. I need me one more beer, one more cigarette. I need me one more beer, baby, one more cigarette before I slip off this bar stool and lose my self-respect. Well, you treated me bad, you left me so sad, you stole my credit cards and left it flat. I need me one more beer, baby, one more cigarette. I need me one more beer, one more cigarette before I slip from this bar stool and swallow my self-regrets. Well, let me see, I've forgotten it now. I've been acting lewd and talking crude. Bartender said it's all right because it went out with you too. I need me one more beer, one more cigarette. That's it, I think. I need me one more beer, baby, one more cigarette before I push from this bar stool and I find myself on the rest. When the clock on the wall reads 4:45, bartender said I can't serve you anymore. I need me one more beer, one more cigarette. Just one more beer, baby, one more cigarette before I fall from this bar stool, cause I drank myself to death.
Woo!
That was great.
She done you wrong.
Look at the nerves.
Blues ain't nothing but a good man feeling bad.
Yeah.
Thank yourself to death.
I wonder if you need one more beer and maybe another cigarette. I don't know.
Just
I couldn't
one more.
Tell. I couldn't quite tell.
I got my beer.
Make me a marijuana cigarette.
Oh, thank you so much. Thank you, chat, for tuning in again. They send a lot of hearts and love, and continue commenting, continue posting. Thank you guys for tuning in again. This is the Music Hour, part of the 48-hour telethon, brought to you by Cam and Fever Radio, in support for the Vengeance Turns Motion Picture.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And Shayne, I did look up Dr. Johnny Fever from what was it? Cincinnati.
WKRP in Cincinnati. This guy's Mr. Cabin Fever, so I assumed that he was like the grandchild of Dr. Johnny Fever.
Yeah. That's great.
and when
how many of us here, seriously, how many of us here are old enough to remember WKRP? I mean, I can show mine right here, but I mean,
I had to look it up.
That's awesome. Yeah, it's like speaks to my heart.
Yeah, so
I can remember. I want to hold your hand.
I can do that. Yeah. So I've been saying, like, at the beginning, I was like, this is WCFR tuning in from the interwebs. And again,
all letters at a time.
I know. So
can't say boogah.
I can dig that. So we'll do another quick round robin. We'll do one song per, just because, again, we are going to go a little bit over what should have been our 9 o'clock spot, but we'll have everybody wait. Hence, I'm also hosting that one, so I'll just push them off. So I was like, one of the jokes that we have in our Cabin Fever Radio crew is that it's like, I am one of the co-founders and executive producers, so I get to do whatever it is that I want.
Yes.
Unfortunately, yeah. And fortunately, that's usually how it goes.
He's drunk with power. He's drunk with power.
And again, one of the...
This man's the dawn of the show, you know? When he talks, people listen.
I am literally the judge of the show. I have a official gavel with me.
Oh, I love it. That's awesome.
But yeah, so if Kate, if you're up for another song, if you want to start off.
I will. Yes. I will start us off. Since the guys weren't here earlier, I picked all country, like old cowboy songs because of
that. I was here. I listened to you.
Okay. Yes. Cool. So this my last song for this evening. This is it's called I Wanna Be a Cowboy Sweetheart. My papa always sang this to me as a kid. And I found out this was a song written by a woman. Her name was actually Ruby Blevins, but her stage name was Patsy Montana. And this song she wrote in the Depression, and it sold 1 million copies. First woman singer. So
that's awesome.
Yeah,
that's
awesome. 1 million that's copies awesome. In the Depression. They had like no money for food, and they sold 1 million copies of this record.
That's great.
Song. So this is how it goes. I wanna be a cowboy sweetheart. I wanna learn to rope and to ride. I wanna ride over the plains and the deserts, out west of the great divide. I wanna hear the coyotes howling while the sun sets in the west. I wanna be a cowboy sweetheart. That's the life I love the best. A little low-do-de-a, a little low-do-de-a, a low-do-de-a, a low-dee. Yeah, a little low-do-de-a, a little low-do-de-a, a low-dee, a low-dee. I wanna ride old paint, get him on a run. I wanna feel the wind in my face, 1,000 miles from all the city lights, going at a cowhand's pace. I wanna pillow my head near the sleeping herd while the moon shines down from above. I want to strum my guitar and a yodel, oh, hee-hee. That's the life that I love. A little low-dee-dee, a little low-dee-dee, a low-dee-dee, a little low-dee-dee, a little low-dee-dee, low-dee-dee. I wanna be a cowboy sweetheart. I wanna learn to rope and to ride. I wanna ride over the plains and the deserts, out west of the great divide. I wanna hear those coyotes howling while the sun sets in the west. I wanna be a cowboy sweetheart. That's the life I love the best. Woo! Thank y'all.
That's great. I love that.
Thank you.
With the little yodel every now and again.
Yeah, I know.
I tried.
You got to check it out.
I tried.
I wanted to pick up my bass guitar, you know, and
yeah.
start playing.
Exactly.
She's got like a fiddle and a banjo playing with her. It's so cool to listen to like her recording.
Yes.
Oh, man. Great. I love that.
Thanks.
Oh, thank you so much,
awesome
Kate.
Awesome job. Awesome.
Yes. And again, just a quick little reminder for you guys, the musicians, as well as the audience member, we do want to turn this into something that we do regularly. So stay tuned. You never know when we announce it officially where we'll be able to do this on a regular basis. Because again, it's one of those things where because we're kind of stuck at home and it gets a little bit tough to be able to do whether it be live events, music shows, even comedy stand-ups and things like that. This will be a good platform to get musicians and artists from all around the nation. Because again, like who is here in LA? So like two just of that, us.
I'm in San Diego. Playing three or four shows a week. I haven't had a gig since
it's hard.
Yeah. So Jack's from San Diego. Corey's from Long Beach. Shayne, you're out that way, correct?
I am east and south, kinda. I'm in Kentucky. Oh, yonder.
In Kentucky, dude. Kentucky, yeah.
Isn't the Derby it's coming up next. This weekend?
Well, howdy, but we don't get to go because I didn't get my $400,000 check from the show, so I don't get to go. Okay,
I wouldn't say that. Been lost in the mail. I got on the phone and talk to somebody about that.
Yeah, it must have been lost in the mail.
I just thought maybe you didn't have your hat ready.
Yeah,
no, I've got my hats.
Yeah, so
priorities like, right there.
Yeah, so being able to have people from all over, pretty much the nation, from the east side all the way to the west side, this will be something cool that we can do, and so we are in the works. We are planning it out. We're trying to figure it out. So soon enough, debuted here on the 48-hour telethon.
That's awesome.
Yes. So just a little insider.
We seem to be doing a good job so far.
Yeah, so far we've been good.
This is working.
Yeah, so far it's been good. So now can we do it even more?
Sure.
And on that note, Jack, if you wish to grace us with another song, it'll be amazing.
Yeah, I'd love to. Thank you. I'm happy to. I had two prepared. I'm going to have to. Let me think.
Noodle one.
Okay, I got one. Okay. You know, this is perfect for this time. This is about dusting yourself off and getting back up. That's basically what it's about. I hope you like. I am red in tooth and claw. God's favorite son, bloodied from the brawl. And this bitterness was killing me all day long. I am not waiting anymore. I am not waiting anymore. I've been blowing through time like nickel slots in a windowless room on a credit card. flashing like a semaphore, vague drafty metaphor. I am not waiting anymore. I've been a keen-eyed observer, movements of concentric parts. Of your body, your bones, your breast, and the map chambers of your heart. And the sand in hand's been turned to glass, like a Jeroboam field of a life that's past. You can jump it off the balcony and listen for the crash. I am not waiting anymore. I spent 8 long years working on my screenplay. It's a teen movie with young actresses that plays to the middle age. I have read between the lines, and I have been wrong every time. Been burned upon the altar, but I am fine. I am not waiting anymore. I am not waiting anymore. I am not waiting anymore.
Very nice. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.
That was beautiful, man.
Yes.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah. No, thank you. Heart. Yes. And again, not to rush, because again, I can push everybody away.
Yes, let's do this. Rush them all. Yes. Let's do it. Let's go. Next guy.
Yeah. So if Corey, if you're ready, if you got one, okay. Hopefully it's the cat one. Just kidding.
I'm not going to play the cat one. Sorry.
Yeah, he's got a plug for Corey. He's got a very awesome song about cats. It's really good.
That's an awesome cat song?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I got to hear this, man. I got to hear it.
No.
I got to hear this, man.
For the next one.
I'm sorry. No pressure.
Yeah, I have a song called Me Out and Lion.
Yeah.
I love it. That's great.
So
it's wonderful.
So stay tuned
You can check it out on my band, The Kind Kind.
Yes.
We got it full recording.
I'm sorry. You broke up. Say the band again, please.
My band is The Kind Kind. Like
the kind of kind.
People,
okay, cool.
Yeah, the kind of people kind, who are yes. kind.
Yeah.
Love it.
And we got a whole arrangement of it.
So yeah.
I'm gonna leave that one to,
yeah, that's the little worm in the hook. So it's like, yeah, stay tuned for that later.
Come back.
Now you have to go find it for yourself.
Yes.
So I got this little synthy synth.
Ooh.
And
nice.
So hopefully I don't mess this up. I don't know. We'll see what's gonna happen.
Yes.
No pressure. It's just like the internet where millions of people can be watching.
Who yeah. knows? Yeah. We're getting a little bit of audio.
Oh, really? I'm hearing so much.
There you go. Yeah. I think it's every time you talk,
you don't hear this?
I think it's your microphone.
Just slightly. I believe it's through your microphone.
You don't hear any of that?
No. We do now.
You do? Okay.
That's voice activated mic.
A little. We can't hear your vocals very much.
Okay, you know what? I'm gonna
switch it up a little.
I'm gonna stick to the guitar.
Because okay.
Apparently, this wasn't meant to be right. Ooh.
Yeah.
This wasn't meant to be right now, so it's okay. It's okay. Because everything is all right.
It's part of the experience of being live.
Hey. You know,
hello and welcome. We are live. We're currently live, as you can tell.
Something was telling me to do it, and something else was telling me to not do it. And apparently the thing that was telling me to not do it was louder by not having any volume.
It's all good. Again, this is still more of an experiment in general, even on our side. So,
cool. Is that better?
Yes.
Is that better? Can you hear my gi?
Yeah. Yes.
Tart. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. All right. Well, this is am I really going to play the Mountain Lion song?
You don't have to. If you have another song, that's fine. Yeah.
You don't have to, but it would be cool if you did, but you don't have to.
No.
This is another kind song. Crippling convenience and cruelty to feed us. And we won't comply, we won't comply. Mass consumption causing mass production is causing mass destruction. And we won't comply, we won't comply. No. All we want is to love. All we want is to be loved. Package up the poison and sell it to our children. And we won't comply, we won't comply. Satisfaction from sad distractions, from our sacred actions. And we won't comply, we won't comply. No. All we want is to be loved. 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 To be loved, to be loved, to be loved. Christian abundation. Watch out for that revelation written. For I've looked to follow with sword. Be a bomb. The
our declarations, confrontations, installations in our brains. Yet this fruition has equated, fully drained the working day. The night has come and all we want is to feel the mandated drops, moving us closer to becoming one. Dreaming of a date where quality will shatter the perception of reality as we honor every single living thing, bend for strangers and moles and trees. See past all the deception, what we thought true was just inception. We're giving it a beast that's assuming your mind, so that's consume all of the lies. Did we take back our own free will? Choosing our mix, spending dollar bills. Everyone's got their own scale. Never shit, we all fulfill. And we won't comply. We won't comply. No. To be loved. All we want is to be loved. All we want is to be loved. All we want is to be loved. And we won't comply. We won't comply.
Nice.
Yes.
Well done, sir. Well done indeed.
Nicely done.
And that's definitely something that we all do want, is want to be loved.
Yeah.
Andy had me dancing.
Yes.
I did. I saw
that was
you.
A first. Yeah.
Grooving. I love that.
That doesn't happen very often with me.
That's definitely a head bopper. That's a head bopper for sure.
Yes.
That's a good one.
Yes, no.
We got a full recording of that up on our all over the social medias.
Songs, yes,
Spotify, iTunes, all of that jazz with the full band, the kind. So
yes,
check it out. I'll definitely look that up. Absolutely,
for sure. And then I'll also get back to all of you guys to share social medias and stuff like that. And before we finish off the night with Shayne, I do want to say again, you can check out Corey and his band, The Kind, all over the webs. And then Jack Norris, where can we find your music?
I'm a hired gun. I've been a guitarist for about 37 years. I'm not really a singer, really. This is all kind of relatively new to me.
You were singing from the heart.
Yeah, you did a great job.
Thank you, man. I appreciate it.
You were singing from the heart. It was nice.
Thank you, man. It means a lot. But I'm San Diego's, lead. I'm a hired guitarist.
Okay.
You can see me. You can find us on I'm in a band called The Social Animal, and some old projects called Tiny Frank. But recently, just since the beginning of 2020, this has been what I'm doing. I've been just posting live me with an acoustic in the corner of my bedroom, playing songs. So this is where you can find me nowadays.
Hey, man.
I can dig that. Yeah.
Find him in the corner of his bedroom.
That's right. I got to keep playing. I got to keep the chops up.
Yes. And Kate, can we find your music somewhere? If you have the recorded music or usually on the big screen.
Yeah. My recorded music is on iTunes and probably CD Baby or something, but it's jazz.
I can dig that. And under Kate Comstock.
Kate Comstock. Yep. Under Kate Comstock. Yep. iTunes, all that kind of stuff. It should pop up.
Look forward to it.
Yeah. 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 So he likes jazz. I'll put it
on the chat so the viewers can see it. And Shayne, where can we find your music?
Mostly Reverb Nation. There I go under Shayne MOR. Because there's another Shayne Moore and it's a girl and I don't want to be confused with her. So I'm Shayne Moore.
But you do have a better hairstyle though, but just.
Oh, please just stop it. I almost put on my eyeliner tonight, but I didn't. But anyway.
Ooh, child.
So Reverbation, there are a few tunes on iTunes, but my stuff is generally a lot heavier than what I've been playing tonight. Mm-hmm. But when you said acoustic, This is where I go when I pick up my acoustic guitar. It's like I told a friend, had I written No Justice Now on the electric, it would have come out sounding more like YouTube, you know, something a little more.
I would like to hear that. I'd like to hear that version of that song.
Yeah.
You know, I may do that.
Do it.
Make it heavy.
Yeah. Maybe for the next rendition of the Music Hour brought to you by Camp Fever Radio. Yeah, yes, so that'd be pretty cool, you know, to test out the waters with new music and stuff like that. But yeah, so again, I put all of the people's bands on the chat so you can see that. Check them out. Look for them on Spotify, Apple Music, all over the webs, Instagrams, and all that fun stuff. Mm-hmm. And yeah, if you want to finish off the night, Shayne, with another ditty.
Okay, I'll tell you what. You may recognize the chord structure. Because it's a lot like beer. But anyway, I wrote this when I was like 14 and had no idea at the time, of course, that I was actually going to marry a woman who was born in Tennessee.
That'll do it.
As we write our own destiny.
Because at 14, I just wasn't thinking about getting married. You know, that was the
you wrote your own destiny.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
I wrote my own destiny. Yeah. Okay. I think it's called Tennessee Woman. Tennessee woman, she's a sure looking fine. Lord, I'm glad she's a friend of mine. I'm feeling Tennessee fine. I'm feeling Tennessee fine. Tennessee woman, don't you act run dry. Oh, I love these Tennessee nights, feeling Tennessee fine. Well, my man a coming to the city below. He's got his moonshine whiskey and a woman named Flo. Feeling Tennessee fine. Feeling Tennessee fine. Tennessee River, don't you ever run dry. Lord, I love these Tennessee nights, feeling Tennessee fine. Well, every Friday night we go running around. I get my Tennessee woman and we're full around. We're feeling Tennessee fine. We're feeling Tennessee fine. Tennessee River, don't you ever run dry. Lord, I love these Tennessee nights, feeling Tennessee fine. And I think it's called Tennessee Fine.
Woo! Yeah.
Yes, sir. Nice. What can you remember, right? It's been a few days.
And I know you played this song for her at least a couple times, right?
So many times that she goes, oh, really, that one again?
You're like, baby,
now,
I wrote
now,
it for you.
Did it work? The question is, did it work? When you played that song for her, did it actually work? Did it work?
The first time I married her. Come on.
That's spectacular.
Right. It worked.
That's
done.
Great.
Done.
I'm going to write a song about how I fell in love with someone from every state.
Yeah.
In my pocket.
Well, being in the traveling band, you can do that, man.
Right.
I want to hear the story about the girl you fell in love with in Maine. What happened in there?
Start writing.
Careful now.
Start writing. But again, thank
She's
you.
Not Maine.
thank you. Thank you so much for being a part of this. I from the bottom of my heart, I truly appreciate it. Thank you
Mr.
for
Kevin
sharing.
Mr. Fever, I love you. I love you.
I didn't hear about any of this until a week before, and now I've read up on the movie you guys are trying to make and the website and all that, and I've been diving in I'm late to the party, but I'm really happy to be part of this and I really
awesome.
Yay.
Thank you.
If you need anything, keep in touch with me. I'd be happy to do this again anytime.
Yes.
This is really great. I'm really happy to be a part of this.
It's definitely something that we do want to continue doing this. Because I've seen how, again, just staying at home has affected a lot of artists.
Yes.
And one of the things that I've told a lot of my friends a little bit on me, I'm usually editor behind camera and I do most of my work already at home. Mm-hmm. So like to me, this is my domain. This is what I love to do. And that's I get to do it from my house, but I've seen my friends who usually go out to shows. My brother, who's an artist, and he goes to events to showcase some of his artwork that he hasn't been able to do. So it's like, how can we do that? And it's a pleasure to have you guys.
This is the way to do it, man. This is great. Yes.
So again, stay in touch, and we'll definitely do this again. And we'll make it bigger, we'll make it grander, and the more people that we can get involved with, the more networking that we can do, the more music we can show people, the better.
All you musicians here, look for me, Jack Norris on Facebook. You'll see my face. Yes. Great. Look for me. I want to follow your stuff. I want to get your stuff. I want to work with you.
If anything, towards the, well, technically I'm running the whole thing. So on Monday, I can also do an email just to link up everybody as well with people's social. Yes.
That'd be great. I would love to keep in touch with all you guys. It'd be great.
Yes. Awesome. It would be my pleasure to host you guys again, because it was fun. It was entertaining for me, and it was entertaining for the world.
We'll be there. Just say the word. Yes. We'll be there.
Awesome. Thank you.
I'd love to be hosted by you again.
Yes. Yes.
I've never been hosted anything quite as well.
Amen.
Anything for Mr. David Ruano.
And to our viewers, thank you so much for tuning in to our music hour and a half. You got to have that half, you know, because again, art kind of tends to take a little bit longer than most of the time that you planned.
Musicians are lazy and we're...
Yeah. And then the host tends to talk a lot, you know, every now and again.
Always making it about you.
Yeah. Well, I am co-founder and executive producer, by the way. Did I not mention that? where's my gavel?
There it is.
Yeah. You're on Cabin Fever Radio.
Here on. Usually you always start with a W or a Q. So WCFR. Thank you for joining us. Thank you guys for being a part of this.
Thank you.
Thank you for letting me be a part of this. This is great. Yes. I love it. This has been great.
And we'll see you on the next one. Again, thank you so much. And we're gonna kick it off to the readings of Brothers Grimm. That's our next show. So if you guys want to continue watching the show, you guys can continue watching the live stream. But again, we're going to kick it off to that. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you.
Bye.
Thanks for having me. Thanks for having us. Great to meet you with all you guys. It's great to meet you guys.
Bye.
Yes, yes.
Y'all
have
awesome.
A good night. Yes.
Peace.
Rock on.
Will do.